Hello everyone. So thank you to I've been doing the test yesterday. It was a pleasure, and even if you did it the test before, it's good to have a review. So today what we will do is we will review the test together. You will take your test, you will open page by page, then you will just follow. We will take an example of my test, and then let's see from here. If you have any question, don't hesitate to give me a call or email me. But the test is very clear. You can go through and really take time to read it. It's a lot of information. So what I will do is I will go out of this screen, and we will go through the test only, the test and yourself and your test as well. Okay, let's do it. So first, on the first page, we'll have your 90 days optimized wellness. So you can go through the third page. The first page is the explanation. You can take time to read as well. Number three. So the page three is actually like what I say is the overall of your report. So you will have this first circle. You will have the priority. The P, the small letter of P, is a priority. So your amino acid, in this case, in my case, is a amino acid as a priority. Resistance is a priority. Interference priority. Food is the letter of A. So A is an advice. And the food means the food restriction. So it's an advice for me for a period of 90 days to avoid this food. So milk, blueberry, kiwi. After, you can go through your list as well. And this is where is the most important thing to follow about your test is the food restriction. Please try to avoid this food for just a period of time, for just 90 days only, and you will really see a difference in your daily lifestyle. The system support is, we will see the next page as well. We will have explanation about this. And so you have environment challenge, fatty acid, vitamin, mineral. So the one who are outside of the circle, mineral in my case, and fatty acid and vitamin, is the smallest one. So which means that I don't need it at the moment. So my body don't request, and I have to focus more on the other one that are bigger block. So let's go to the next page, page four. So page four, you have a system support indicator. So your system support indicator show actually also the overall of the test, which is important. But there is some word that is some wording that is a bit confusing when you are not a professional or not a nutritionist. So what I suggest is just not to worry about some wording, like in my case, oxidative stress, fatty acid metabolism, protein synthesis, musculoskeletal system, so which is a bone system, and oxidative stress. Protein is related to my protein. So all of these are actually linked to the food later on the test that I need to increase. So what you have to look at is just, you can just look at the name, but mostly is you have to look at the food that will help you to increase and will help you to get rid of it, or just like have it as an advice, because in this case, in my case, is a priority at the moment. So the one that are outside are actually really good. I have no issue sleeping. Brain health is fine. Adrenal system is also fine. So the smallest block are also really good for me. Okay, the circulatory support indicator. So just take time to read. The text actually explain everything also. You can see that he explain how to read it, and just take time to read. The test inform everything and is very easy to understand. So in this case, you have seven. For me, I have 7+ indicator, which is vitamin E, C, B6, carnosine. So all the green one are the one that I need to increase. And later on, again on the test, we will see if it's a priority for me, or advice, or just a consideration. Okay, exercise. Of course, this one is in every test, so you will have an indicator that is very important to follow all this. Exercise, lifestyle, other, and sexual health. Okay, your vitamin indicator, so you have all vitamin. So this, in my case, you can see C is a consideration. So and you have to increase intake, but just as a consideration. So consideration is after we will see the list of food linked to my B12, biotin, vitamin C, vitamin B6. So as a consideration for myself, I will not take supplement and I will really go with the food. This test is really a nutritional food. So you need to follow the test properly and just go by the list of food that they suggest. If it's a priority, I would suggest to go with a supplement, but once again, this is your choice. Choice of supplement, choose the right one, and that's it. So because now in the market, there is a lot of supplement that are with a lot of chemical, a lot of food additive, a lot of coloring, and can be also dangerous. So instead of taking supplements, I will rather go for some food. And of course, organic food sometimes, which is a bit difficult also now to find, but you still can find in some supermarket, organic supermarket, like Maota, where we went yesterday in Singapore. Okay, so every page you have also a lot of information about vitamin and the food rich foods about vitamin as well. So also, once again, you take time to read it. Your mineral indicator is just a consideration for me. So once again, I will go calcium, copper. I will go with natural food and natural water. So what I do to get all my mineral, I'm taking a quarter of teaspoon of sea salt, of Celtic salt, actually from France, which is very nice. So every morning I take a quarter of teaspoon in a glass of water. A few zest of lemon juice and all my mineral become balanced. So in a Celtic salt, I think it's something like 92 minerals. The Himalayan salt is also very good. You have about 88 minerals, a little bit less, but it's good. And you can also, but be careful also once again with Himalayan salt. You have a lot of fake in the market, which they could put also some coloring. So be careful, but that's why I'm going more with Celtic salt, which is from the sea and have a little bit more mineral and is natural. There is no chemical inside. Okay, a lot of information about natural mineral food. Fatty acid indicator. So once again, for me, is a consideration. I also have ALA, AC3, so this one is an omega-3. Okay, you have omega-3, 6, and 9 in this case, so in this report. So what, in my case, what I do and what to get my ratio correct, I'm taking a blend of oil, flaxseed oil, and so it's also natural, which I use is called Udo's oil. So Udo's oil is actually in my store. If you go to www.skillsharpening.store on the nutrition part, you can see all my supplements and the good one. And you can see Udo's oil, which is very good and can make all of this balance and without taking any fish oil, because sometimes also even fish oil is toxic. Now you know the sea is a little bit is not so safe, and with a lot of plastic and a lot of toxicity. So fatty acid, you can see the page about the information about fatty acid. Of course, fresh fish, you can get fresh fish if you are not vegetarian, and once again try to get much organic as possible. It's very difficult to get organic fish nowadays, but you can still find in a nice fresh sea, you find some good fish. Okay, antioxidant. Antioxidant for me is an advice, so I have to increase to intake. So for me, it was a bit difficult. The last test that I did, I have to avoid strawberry and blueberry because, okay, on the first test, I have to increase my blueberry and strawberry. And on this test, I have to stop for a period of 90 days, blueberry and strawberry, for example. So I stopped my increase of blueberry and strawberry for a period of 90 days. And so I have another list of food that I can find this antioxidant, but it was a bit difficult for me to find. So that's why now the test came in with some advice on the antioxidant. So now I just re-increase my strawberry and blueberry. So once again, it's just to do this test every 90 days is very important, and you will really find it accurate to you, and this is good to get balance as much as possible. So the goal of this test is to get balance and to avoid also the wrong food. So like in my case, you have flavonoid, vitamin C, vitamin E, polyphenol, I got a lot. Once again, Q10, I also got a lot. So sometimes antioxidant you can go with a supplement, but we did some tests with supplement in the market now with antioxidant, and believe me, many antioxidants are not safe as a supplement, which the one I suggest from my store is Usana, which you can do some tests also with different kind of antioxidant, and you will find it that Usana are the most safe, and they don't put any coloring, anything inside. That's very important. So because now even the blueberry and even some many food, the antioxidant is a colorful food and vegetable. So everything now is contained chemical and coloring even in a food. So they to make it more red, for example, a capsicum, they will put something to make it more colorful. They will always put something which is not safe. Okay, so you have a full list about antioxidant as well, full information. So take time to read it. Amino acid. Amino acid is a priority in my case. So alanine, carnosine, okay. Amino acid, you will find some difficult name that even me, I don't understand. But what you can do, and what I do sometimes, is I just use Google. So I Google it. Carnosine, alanine, pelacanine, leucine, okay. Then I Google if I want to go with supplements, but later on you will have a food list to go with it. But if I want to increase my supplement, you can check which supplements are good and safe which contain carnosine only or contain alanine only, because there is, and you can go for it. Okay. See, that's the list about amino acid. Okay, environment challenge. So the environment challenge is something that's also very important. So in my case, I have the last test, I have radiation coming up in red as a priority. In this test, came out as a consideration. So I work on it. To get rid of this radiation, I walk barefoot on the grass. Or I just take a chair, I just sit down barefoot, and I read a book for 1 hour, 1.5 hour, and to just get the power of Earth and get electricity, the good electricity back from Earth, get into your body, and to get rid of this radiation. There is food after, there is food to get rid of it, but mostly radiation is earthing, grounding, which I suggest in Singapore to go on the beach, on the wet sand, sometime in Sentosa, that's the only place, or East Coast, or you just go in your garden, but at least stay at least 1 hour, and believe me, if you try to do at least 1 hour every day or every 2 days, at least is okay. You will really see the difference, you will sleep better, and you will feel more energized as well. So that's something important. Toxic metal, if you have toxic metal You will have the full list, which you can check, because toxic metal now is everywhere. You can even find toxic metal, as I say, in a lipstick. So every product contains toxic metal. Many products, not every product, but many products like drinks, canned drinks, you know, so you have to really be careful about this. Chemical and hydrocarbon. You can also, that's linked also to a lot of with the pollution, the environment where you live. If you live where people smoke, or even if you smoke yourself, you will have this issue. If you drink alcohol also, you will have this issue. If you drink a lot of alcohol, I mean. So sometimes it come in, come out. So that's also something easy to get rid of, but toxic metal is a bit more difficult. By grounding and by the food. So here you have a list of food to balancing environment exposure. Okay, resistance. So resistance as a priority for me, I have more than 4, but you can see you have a list of post virus, parasite, virus, bacteria, fungus. Once again, when you see yourself, sometimes you can see 3. Post-virus, virus, sometimes you can see bacteria, parasites. So once again, this is, don't worry, is this one was your environment, your last 90 days, and you have your next 90 days to get rid of it. So you don't have to worry. There is always a solution to every problem. And this test gives you a solution, actually. So when you go on the next page, they give you the food resistance to increase, which I find it very useful, in my case, for garlic and ginger mostly. So I do garlic and ginger every day. I'm eating garlic and ginger every day. Ginger as a tea, garlic in my food, and this very help pineapple as well, and really help me to get rid of all those parasites and all those resistance. Frequency interference indicator. Okay, this one is a priority for me for some blocks. You can see magnetic constant field, low frequency radiation, electromagnetic field. You will have also a mobile phone, microwaves. So this one, once again, is something that on your daily lifestyle is your environment, is your choice, to change it. And this is something that in Singapore, yes, it's not easy because you have many radiation, many Wi-Fi, many phone, many TV, many lights around you, a lot of light, and it's difficult to get rid of. But it's possible. It's possible. Switch off your Wi-Fi at night. Do a little thing like try to avoid microwaves. If you see a big tower, electricity tower, try to don't go around it or don't live nearby. Because in Singapore, you can see like some big tower, like a Singtel and a phone, mobile phone tower that are completely in the city. Even people live at least 50 meters from here, from the tower, which is completely unbelievable. But this one is your choice. The choice is yours. You have to get information about this that is dangerous for you. In the long term, you will find some effect. So try to really avoid it. I can give you more information about all of this as well, but you have also information in the test later on. I will show you where. Okay, that's also information on the next page. And the food, of course, we will get rid of it. Vitamin D3. The most vitamin D3 is your sun. You need to go out. In Singapore, many people are in lack of vitamin D3 because it's really hot and they don't go out during the day. So try to go in the morning or in the evening where the UV is not too strong. You just take 1 hour and you stay outside. Increase your spirulina, which is really good as well. Okay, your 90 days food restriction. So once again, this one is good. I print every day. I print the page and I put every day in my fridge, or I keep with me. Then I know when I go shopping, I know which food I need to buy and which food I need to avoid. So this for me in my case is an advice. So I avoid milk, cod, kiwi, lime, quinoa. eggplant, artichoke. So this is something important to avoid, food restriction. You can go through this page, it's very important to read it, about your energy flow and about the food restriction. That's very good information. And it completely makes sense, it completely makes sense to avoid. Food additive avoidance, an advice. So this is everywhere, food additive, you can find it. Even in this page of food additive, you can find it some in your daily products such as soap and hair cream, all those kind of things. That me, I find it here, so which is very accurate. Like I said, this one Brilliant Blue, it was in a small chocolate sweet that I remember that I eat a lot during my last 90 days from my pastry chef. And I have a lot of testing, and I know that those chocolate contain this. So this is something that you need to get rid of. If you see aluminium as well somewhere, sometime, that's something not good, you need to avoid. Okay, this one, you click here, if you click to every you will have electromagnetic field and information and toxin information and food additive information. So these three are really good. So what you can do is from this food additive, you just click to this link, food additive, and you will see the one that are dangerous. So when you link with your test, you find out the food sometime that you eat that you don't know or you don't remember, then you try to avoid it. Or product that you use. And what you can do, sometime I just Google one by one, then you Google the picture, then you will see, oh, that's the product I use, oh, that's the product I eat. So try to avoid it. And your 90 days wellness food. So once this one you can print as well, when you go shopping, you at least try to, like they say, introduce as many food as you can, at least two for each indicator. So two when you go to do your shopping, two every week, and then you increase in your daily life, in your daily food. I find it that the first line is a priority, and the first food who came on the first line is always the one that I really increase, which is, in my case, is spirulina and beef, lamb. So those three I really try to increase, and I really, really, really see the difference. I really feel better by taking this. Beef as well for the carnosine, alanine. So you see in this case, you can really go for the grass-fed beef, which is really good, and you don't need to take a supplement for that. Vitamin C, you can find it here. So vitamin C, I always suggest a little bit of supplement, a good supplement as vitamin C, which I take. From Usana, but you can increase also with the food, but sometimes it's not easy to increase your vitamin C with food, so that's why I always take a bit of supplement. Your B12 as well, biotin, copper. So after you go through your list, your own list, and try to increase as much as possible for 90 days, and you will see the difference. ALA, so this is walnut, flaxseed, canola. So all this oil is a blend of oil, which you can find in Udo's oil, which is my store, and this one is very good blend of oil. And your 90 days wellness food, so your environment food, radiation, they suggest green tea, garlic, onion, wheatgrass, and coconut oil, and probiotic whole food. And of course, I suggest grounding, earthing, wear barefoot, and just relax, read a book, de-stress. And a good quality drinking water, so avoid tap water and plastic bottle, of course. Try to avoid as much as you can as possible and go with a glass bottle. And your essential fatty acid, which they suggest here as well. Okay, then after you have your self-check progress. So your self-check progress, you have 30 days. Then 60 days, you have 30 days, your 60 days, your 90 days, and then after is your choice to do it again, do your test again, and go and on. So It's only 4 times a year if you calculate. Every 3 months, you're doing this test 4 times a year and you try to get balance as much as possible. And after a year, believe me, I did it for now about, it will be about 8 months. So I did the test 3 times already. My first test, second test, third test came out. And I really see the difference and more energy in my life. I get less sick. I'm going to see the doctor I never go to see the doctor actually for the last 8 months that I did the test because I really follow this test, and which is good. I really try to avoid all those drugs that the doctor suggests. Of course, if you are very sick and if you have any issue, sometimes you have no time to, no choice, I mean, to take antibiotic. But for me, I really try to go naturally and go with the food. So go through the test. This is also very good, question and answer. So that's all the question that sometimes you need to ask me. Please take the time. Go through the test, go through this question. This question and answer are very, very good and very understanding. So just take time to read. And okay, I come back here. Hi. Okay, so just hi, take time to read the test. I see you again in 90 days after your report. You will receive some email from me. So I will be leaving soon for the next 2 months to France, to my hometown. And then I'm coming back to Singapore. So just be happy, be healthy, follow the test, and everything will be fine. See you soon.